The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on June 29, 1974, in Melbourne, Australia.
So here it is said, the assumption means without doubt, and samagram means incomplete. Those who are philosophers speculating what is God, what is absolute truth, they cannot know. That is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Atāpi te deva padām bhujadvayam prasāja leśāṁ grihita eva hi jānāti tattam nacāna ekopi chiraṁ vichinna. One who is who has gotten a little favor of Krishna, God, he can understand. Atāpi te deva padām bhujadvayam prasāja. One who has got little mercy of the lotus feet of Krishna. Atāpitevi padām bhujadvayam prasādalesa. Little mercy. Jñānāti tattam. He can understand what is God. Little favor. Not all favor. A little. Others, chiraṁ vichinnam, they may go on speculating, imagining what is God. God may be like this, God may be like that, God may be like that. So in that way, chiraṁ vichinnam, for many, many millions of years, if one thinks like that, he cannot understand. Therefore, Krishna comes himself and he manifests his pastimes in Vrindavan. As cowherd boy, how he is playing with his friends, how he is dealing with Radharani, how he is dealing with his parents, everything is manifested practically, just like ordinary human being. But at the same time, whenever there is need, big demands, beginning from Putana, when he was only a few months old, he is maintaining his position as God, but dealing with his devotees, his father, mother, friends, lover, all in Vrindavan, who are they? They are expansion of Krishna. That story we have got in the Krishna book, the Brahma stole all the cows and calves and cowherd boys stolen. Krishna immediately creates another set. Then Brahma understood that he is the Supreme Lord, my master. So, the Krishna's associates, they are all also Krishna, expansion of Krishna. Ananya chinmaya rasa pradibhavitadhi tadhi ja eva nijarupa payakaladhi. We are also expansion of Krishna. We living entities, Krishna says in the Bhagavad, mamai bhansa, part and parcel. So, samagram, one has to understand actually what is Krishna incomplete. If you want to know that, then this is the process. Mayi asakta mana. The mind has to be engaged in Krishna. First thing, mind. Therefore, Krishna manifests himself in this deity form. The deity is Krishna himself. But we cannot concentrate Krishna, which is not visible. Krishna is not visible to the ordinary eyes. Atasya Krishna nabhavet grahyam indriyai. God is not perceptible without this material eyes or material senses. Atasya Krishna Namadi, even material ears, you are chanting. If you are not spiritually advanced, this chanting of Hare Krishna mantra also will not appeal. It will be hackneyed, mechanic. But by chanting, you gradually advance Cheta Darpana Marjanam, then you will understand that this Hare Krishna mantra is not different from Krishna. The mantra, the sound vibration is also Krishna. So, we have to repose our mind to the form of Krishna. Krishna says, Mai, and to me, Krishna. We cannot see now Krishna personally. Personality is here. But we want to see anything physically. Physically he is also there. Here, Krishna Murti is physical. But because we are differently educated, we do not know what is this world of physics. We think that this is different from Krishna. That will be explained. Therefore he says, Tachinu Asamsam Samadrama Jatha Gyasasi Tachinu. You just hear from me. As you can understand me in complete, without any doubt. So Krishna is instructing himself about himself. Why there should be any doubt? There cannot be any doubt. God is explaining himself about him. Then why there should be doubt? This is the we call bhakti yoga, madhasya. Maya sakta mana partha. So how you can engage your mind in the Supreme Personality of Godhead if you do not know the form? Therefore Krishna comes in his original form. Yada yadahi dharmasya glani bhavati bhara tadatmanam sijamaham. When people forget or become engaged otherwise, raskalna, yuskitina, at that time he comes. He comes himself or sends his representative to make this rascal know that here is Krishna. Tadatmanam sijami aham. In the form of name, in the form of deity, in the form of picture, in the so many ways. If you think of Krishna within yourself, that Krishna is like this, Krishna's leg is like this, Krishna's feet is like this, Krishna's hand is like this, mouth is like this, his desk like this. This meditation is perfect meditation, not imagination. So that your mind will be gradually absorbed in Krishna. So Krishna comes therefore, personally, and exhibits this Krishna Murti, just like here is the picture of your spiritual master. So you worship this picture. You know that this is my spiritual master's picture. Similarly, if somebody disregards this picture, he will not tolerate. Similarly, Krishna's deity and Krishna are not different. I was explaining this morning. Krishna has come kindly to accept your service as you can deal with him. If Krishna comes in his gigantic form, Krishna has got gigantic form also as it was shown to Arjuna, you will not be able to capture him, neither you have any means to dress him. Suppose the universal form of Krishna is there and you have to dress him, so the whole cloth factory will be finished. Is it not? How you can dress? You have no capacity to dress. But Krishna has kindly accepted a form, this beauty. You can purchase cloth according to your means and with your great devotion, you can dress. Similarly, the gigantic Virat Rupa, universal form, the whole, it is described in Bhagavad Gita that he is eating the whole humanity. It is going on in his mouth. Then why do you get such food? The whole humanity, whole universal living entities can be devoured by Krishna. But because you are not able to offer such gigantic food to Krishna, Krishna says, all right, give me patram pushpam phalam priyam. Give me a little flower, give me a little fruit, give me a little water, I shall accept. This is called archan vidhi. Krishna has agreed to accept your service as you can afford to do. It is not idol worship. It is actually worshipping Krishna. So, therefore, Krishna says, Maya Sapta Manapat. This simply, you have to increase your attachment for Krishna. This is bhakti. We have got attachment for so many things. Our attachment is now dispersed in so many ways. You have to concentrate that attachment to Krishna. Then your business will be successful. Bhakti yoga. Maya sakta mana. Mind. Savi mana Krishna palarvinda. Somewhere or other, you have to engage your mind at the lotus feet of Krishna. Therefore, so many paraphernalia. How to engage your mind? Savanam, kirtanam, Krishna, hearing about Krishna, chanting about Krishna, thinking of Krishna, worshipping Krishna, talking about Krishna, writing about Krishna, selling the books about Krishna, eating Krishna prasadam. In this way, you become Krishnaized, all around Krishna. That is Krishna. This is called bhakti yoga. This is called bhakti. Somewhere or other, you become surrounded by Krishna atmosphere. This is Krishna. Maya sapta mana partha yogam. This is yoga. Madhasa. Not madhasa means taking center of me. So, taking center of me to beginning teaching. Understand now, Krishna taking shelter of Krishna's representative. Guru Krishna kripaya paya bhakti lata bij. By Krishna's mercy one gets Guru, and Guru's mercy one gets Krishna. So if one is sincere, he takes advantage of Guru's mercy and Krishna's mercy, and then he will prepare. This is called bhakti yoga. Not that I am now very much advanced, I don't require any help from my Guru, as somebody is doing. This is Askela. You cannot get Krishna by overcoming Guru. That is not possible. Therefore, Chaitanya Chaitanya says, Guru Krishna kripaya paya. You should always remember that by the mercy of Krishna, we get Guru. And by the mercy of Guru, we get Krishna. So we have to seek mercies of both of them. So, Maya Sakta, Madhasraya. Madhasraya means, Madhasraya. One, Guru means, who has taken full shelter of Krishna. He is Guru. A Guru does not mean that he has taken shelter of somebody else and he has become Guru. That is not. Guru means one who has taken full shelter, complete surrender to Krishna, is Guru. Or he speaks only what is spoken by Krishna. Just like we are speaking in the Bhagavad Gita as it is. There is no malinterpretation. Krishna says, Sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saranam vraja. The Guru will teach his disciple that you surrender to Krishna. Krishna is God. He is saying, surrender to me. And Guru is saying, you surrender to Krishna. Therefore the statement is the same. Krishna says, manmana bhavamad bhaktamadjyaji mag namaskuru. So Guru will say the same thing, that you always think of Krishna. You become a devotee of Krishna. You offer worship to Krishna. You offer your obeisance. This is Guru's business. Not that, because in the Shastra it is said, the Guru should be honored as Krishna as Bhagavan. Therefore, Guru will think, I have become Bhagavan. No, that is Mayava. The disciple will offer as respect, as much respect he offers to Krishna or to Guru. That is the Shastra in general. But for that reason, the real Guru will not think that I have become Krishna. Kintu prabho ja priya eva tas jasya prasadad bhagavat prasad. By the mercy of Guru, you get the mercy of Krishna. If Guru approves that here is a nice devotee, then Krishna accepts, yes, here is a nice devotee. So therefore, jasya prasadad, our business is to please Guru. If he is satisfied, then Krishna immediately becomes satisfied. He is the agent. That is very easy to understand. Suppose you are working in office, your immediate boss, the superintendent, if he is pleased, that means the managing director is also pleased. You haven't got to please the managing director separately. If you please his representative, then the managing director sees the report. Yes, this man is working there. Then he accepts. He has never seen it. But that is not the fact. Krishna also seeing you. So this is called madāśrita, junyan, mayāsaktamanātmārtha yugam junyan madāśrita. You have to take shelter of Krishna. And Krishna, because you have no direct touch of Krishna, therefore you take shelter of Krishna's representative. Then this yoga begins. He will teach you how to practice the bhakti yoga. How to worship him, how to think of him, how to offer obeisance, how to observe the ceremonies, just like yesterday we performed the ceremonies, Ratha Yatra. So the dress, Jagannath dress, and function, everything you have to learn. This is called Bhakti Yoga, Madhasya. And this, the beginning is Maya Asakta Mana, Asakta. Asakti, we have to develop attachment. If you do not develop attachment for Krishna, then other things does not come. So this asakti attachment has to be practiced. That asakti, there is rules and regulation, the method how you can develop, increase your attachment for Krishna. So, the first thing is arusadhya, faith, that if I become Krishna conscious, I will be happy. That is my goal of life. This is called sadhya. If I have no sadhya, that by loving Krishna, by surrendering to Krishna, my life will be perfect, that is perfection of life, then there is no beginning of bhakti yoga. The first thing is this. Just like Krishna says, sarva-dharmān parityajya mamekam saraṇam bhaja. So you give up all other engagements, just surrender to me. So if you have got faith actually, then you can devote yourself fully, 100% in the service. This is the beginning. Agosundhya. Yes, Krishna says that by surrendering to him, I shall be free from all sinful reaction. If you have got faith, then you surrender, and actually you will be free from all sinful reaction. Krishna says, Krishna is not making any bogus propaganda. He said, Aham tva sarva pape bhamo khoishan. I shall get you released from all reaction of sinful life. You are suffering because there is reaction of sinful life. But if you surrender to Krishna, then your all reaction of sinful life is immediately nullified, squared up. So this is the process of bhakti yoga. You surrender, and in the past, whatever sinful activities you have done, they are squared up. Now, account closed. Now you begin a new life, devotional. And if you stick to the principle as it is instructed, that do not have illicit sex life, do not have intoxicants, do not eat meat, do not play gambling, speculate, you promise before Krishna and before the spiritual master, before the Vaishnavas, so many witnesses, and if you violate, then you can understand what you are doing. You promise before the deity. Krishna is not defined. So an initiation takes place. We promise so many things, but if we do not follow, if we do not keep our promise, that is a great fault. If you, by chance, by mistake, you violate the regulative principle, that is excused. But if willingly, if you go on committing sinful life, just like in the churches they go to confess and again begin, that kind of business will not help. That kind of business will not help. I have confessed. Now I begin a new chapter of sinful life. Again I shall confess. Krishna is not so poor that he can cheat him by this process. No, that is not possible. You can be excused the process of your advancement unwillingly. If you commit some mistake, that will be excused. That is said in the Bhagavad Gita. Opite sudurachara bhajati imamananda bhav sadureva samantabha. Sometimes we take shelter of this verse, that opite sudurachara, I have sinfully remained my deed. Bhajati imamananda, if he is fully engaged in my service. But this word is very important. One cannot be fully engaged in the service of Krishna unless he is purified. Jesam antagatam papam jananam punyakarmanam. One who is completely free from reaction of sinful life and is always engaged in pious activities, such person can be Krishna conscious. So it is not that one is a divorce at the same time a Krishna conscious. So that is a contradiction. It cannot be. If he is actually Krishna conscious, he cannot be divorced. And if he is divorced, then he is not Krishna conscious. Two things cannot go parallel. So, no. We are. If we are fully surrendered to Krishna, Krishna takes our all sinful, because continually we are suffering. What is that? Because, just like the same example, infection. I am infected, say, two, three kinds of disease. So I am suffering from one infection, again another infection. They come. They take time. Just like if you sow a seed, it's not that immediately becomes a big tree and fruits. No, it takes some time. Similarly, our papabijam, the seed of sinful activities, we take it, but in the immediately we may not see that it is fructified, but it will in due course of time. It will. Same level. That one has infected cholera bacteria. So not that immediately he is attacked with cholera. Say after a few days. Therefore, the injection is given and the time is allowed in the medical treatment. So that if the infection has actually working, the disease will come. So immediately we may not see that we are infected with some certain type of sinful activities, but it will come into notice. And that is going on. Therefore we shall be careful not to infect. And how to become careful? If you always engage yourself in Krishna service, therefore the deity worship in the temple is there. To keep us always engaged, not only duty worship, the class, reading, hearing, kirtan, in so many ways, there are 9 different kinds of ways. Shravanam, kirtanam, vishnu, smaranam, padasevanam, archanam, bandhanam, dasam, sakkamam. Anyway, if you keep yourself always engaged in Krishna consciousness, in Krishna's business, then you are immune. You will not be infected. This is the problem. You keep yourself always engaged in Krishna consciousness business, you always remain immune. Sagunan samatitta itan brahma bhuyat. And willfully we shall not do anything which against the bhakti process. Willfully. But because I am habituated, suppose a smoker, he has taken to Krishna consciousness, yeast, has promised that I shall not smoke or I shall not. But all of a chance, sudden, suppose his friends induces him, what is that, smoke today. Sometimes we become induced. But we should always remember that I have taken this vow. Why shall I be induced by my friend to smoke? That is very nice. But even if by mistake you do that, that can be excused. But not willfully. Nobody is saying, Krishna is not here, let me smoke now. Not Krishna's eyes are everywhere. You cannot escape Krishna's eyes. So in this way, this verse says that increase your attachment upon me. That attachment can be, the process is this, that first of all you must have full faith in Krishna. All full faith in the words of spiritual master. That is the beginning. If you have no faith, there is no question of advance. To advance, there is no question. Finished, then everything is finished. The first thing is faith. Then we have to associate with persons who have faith. Sadhusam. This is our opening of different centers means we are giving chance. So those who are inmates of the temple, they should be also such nice devotees that anyone who will come in the association of devotees, he will immediately develop a sense of devotion. That is the duty, those who are managing this temple. By his character, by his behavior, he will be influenced. This is next step. First of all, faith, the next step is to associate with devotees. The devotees must be also sincere devotees, otherwise what will be the effect of such association? Adho saddha tato sadhu sangha. Then, gradually, he will be inclined to become one of the devotees. He will request the president, sir, you recommend me for being initiated. I am interested. That is called bhajanakriya. Adho saddha tato sadhu sangha ato bhajanakriya. That bhajana kriya is initiated, the activities begins officially. Then as he makes advance in this bhajana kriya or activities in devotional service, then anartha nivittisya, then all the unwanted things, the so-called illicit sex life, meat eating, drinking, gambling, even after smoking and drinking tea, finished, anarthani vittishya. Then you become pure. This verse explains that, how you can increase your devotional life, how you can become perfect, how you can know God perfectly, samagram, asamsam, without any doubt. This is the verse. Thank you.